Hello friends, and welcome to this course on learning complete Salesforce.com CRM. So in this course, we will cover the complete admin as well as the developer part of the Salesforce, and we will talk about some new features as well. The first thing is we need to understand that Salesforce.com is a CRM. CRM stands for Customer Relationship Management, okay? A lot of people have this confusion what a CRM is, what a ERP is, and what all these things are there. So basically, let's say we have an industry, a manufacturing plant maybe. There's a company which manufactures some product. Now the plant which is on in which the product is being manufactured, it has got its own component like the raw material, the machinery, the staff, their salaries and everything. The accounting part, the government taxes and all. So all those kind of things, when we need to manage those things, in that case we need ERP. Now once the product has been manufactured, that product needs to be sold. So there comes the sales and marketing part. And once the sales and marketing is complete, a customer buys it, then there is a support, the service part of the product. So after sales service, which we call it. So if we talk about the manufacturing unit, so it will involve the use of ERP. And if we talk about this front end thing, which is interacting with customers, there comes CRM, okay? So Salesforce plays a role in these fields, marketing, sales, your analytics reports, how many leads have been generated, how many leads got converted to opportunities and all. Then Service Cloud, Salesforce has a product known as Service Cloud for the service part, after sales support and all those things. So these kind of product Salesforce deals in, okay? So basically we are clear that Salesforce is a CRM. Now, when we need to work on Salesforce, if you have a Salesforce account, if you're working with an organization and you already have a Salesforce account, then it's well and good. But if in case you do not have, Salesforce gives a lifetime free account for your practice, okay? A lifetime free developer account, okay? So it has almost all the features, just the licenses, number of licenses are less in this. Now to register for a lifetime free account in Salesforce, you need to go to developer.salesforce.com or developer.force.com. Alternatively, if you go to, let's go to salesforce.com direct. Sorry, it's open.org. ORG is basically the non-profit part of Salesforce, the Salesforce Foundation, where they give 10 license free of cost to non-profits. Okay, so here are the product. Let's say I go to Sales Cloud. Sales Cloud is the most widely used product of Salesforce. It is the oldest one as well. I click on learn more. So here you can learn about this, everything here, the pricing and all. Okay. Now another thing is that Salesforce sells license per user basis. So the enterprise edition, they say it's most popular. So it's basically $125. If you buy in bulk, this is customizable. You can talk with your account manager and they do give discounts on this as well. Okay. So this is the Sales Cloud, which is the mostly used product. If I go to getting started here. Okay. So here on the getting started, you can see all the knowledge about Salesforce, how to do that, how to find a partner. There's a Salesforce app exchange, and we will see all these things in this course. Okay, let's go to pricing once again. And if I click here, try for free. Okay, so you can even sign up here as well, but this will be a 30-day trial of Salesforce, and this will basically give you the production environment. But what we will do, instead of this, we will sign up for a developer account, and signing up is very easy. Just click on sign up here and need to fill a small form. The only thing is that you need to provide your username in the format of an email, that's all. Okay, so you need to just fill in this form here. And the username should be in the format of an email. It could be abc@xyz.com, but it should be in the form of email. So we need to sign up here. Once you sign up, you will receive an email and you will be asked to verify your account email ID and change your password at the first moment. Or not, I will not say change, I will say assign a password to your account. So once you sign up, you will receive an email and then you can go to login.salesforce.com. In future, whenever you will come back to work on Salesforce, you can simply go to login.salesforce.com. So these were things, how to work on Salesforce, how to create a free account. I have already signed up to create the course. Okay, so once I log in, it will take me to the salesforce.com. Now, a lot of people ask me that what is the difference between Salesforce and there are many other CRM which are out there in the market. Why Salesforce is so famous? See, the major part of Salesforce being famous is it is cloud-based product. You don't need any hardware, you don't need any networking. Only thing you need is browser and internet connection. Like we use our Gmail account, in the same way we can use Salesforce account. You simply go to login.salesforce.com in your browser and you can sign into Salesforce. Now, being on cloud, it has got its many benefits. As I told you that you don't need any hardware, any after sales support kind of thing and all those stuff. So you hardly have any hardware breakdown or any network breakdown. You don't face those issues. And it's pay as you go model. If let's say if you sign up for a Salesforce account in May and in June you think I will not be using CRM much, so you can just simply ask Salesforce to do not charge you for the June month. Then July you can start your payment again. So these kind of facilities are there. Secondly, it's auto upgradable. If you install a software in your premise on a hardware, to upgrade it you will need to hire a consultant. You need to pay that fees again for the upgradation as well. But Salesforce is auto upgradable. You don't need to upgrade anything. Salesforce from the back end, they upgrade Salesforce every 4 months. Okay, every 4 months there's a new release of Salesforce, so it upgrades automatically in the back end. You don't need to do anything, just need to sign up, pay for the license fees, go to login.salesforce.com. This is I'm talking about people who are into business, who are buying a production environment. But to learn as a developer, you can even go for a free lifetime developer account and you can start working as a developer. Okay, so this was more about the course. As I told you in the beginning as well, we will cover almost everything in this course, and this course will add some value to your life. Hopefully you will enjoy the course. See you till then. Take care. Bye bye.